Hi, this is Mailroom part three of, or part, I don't know if it's part three or four, but continuing. We're going back to the truck layout, dude. I'm sorry, I had to cut the tape. All right, what I did is an oblique transcription. All right, this would be your three bowl side baluster on the other right side. And then you'd go through the center in this middle one. Remember the auxiliary rear, or the thing. And here's one wheel, and then I drew a little circle over here so you see the other wheel, maybe a traction motor right there. And then it looks kind of sloppy. I taped it all together. Like, I hate taking these apart because they tell the ingenious of the machine. Here would be like where your draft yoke goes in, and then, or like you complete a slave with this piece of anti-creep, which really, that's I borrowed from. This would be your front part of your slab for your truck. And what happens when you have the anti-creep, you go back to the baby drawing, dude, right? The baby, right? That's the baby. So this anti-creep, this would create a slave if you put like a spring in here. We'll just do this real quick. I got a little baluster spring. We'll just say this is kind of like a draft yoke spring setup in between the center baluster and the end of the yoke and draft gear. And then you got your stairs in the front. Got your stairs in your front. All right, you got the trucks. You'd have your, this is, say you looked at this around as square, you'd have a glove mating section, your hang off cutter lever, and then a set of stairs going up to the track, main locomotive mount. So basically what we're telling you is this is what the center baluster is going to look like. This is the draft gear anti-creep. Like, where's that? T-square. Just, this is the frame. Think of this as slab, one big slab, but kind of like folded, so it has a T, like a square piping inside, and it pushes on the yoke, presses the lever, breaks down back to, let's see, this was our anti-creep drawing. We have this. That will probably be the rear. And then we're gonna do like just to keep it on one, so it's one motion. We have either your this can flip around or eliminate one line. You'd have just from end front cab to back cab, somewhere in the middle, the Z brake, Z town, Zephyr Hills, you know. And then like we'd have an adjuster, slack adjuster, brake and chain, brake cylinders are optional here and here, ready to leave the line. And then you have like this combination. That's why I draw it with a dash. So which way ever you wanted to pull the back brake. Notice I put on the door chain. I don't know if I made a video for that yet. And then